so excited to do this interview because, like, Judy Blume is the reason that I became a reader. She's the reason I became a writer. She's the reason that I understood what was happening to my body.
Yes.
All of those things. So
I am with you. I know you 100%. Yes. Right?
I know why you made the movie, but I want to know, what made you want to bring this beloved novel to the screen?
Well, first of all, everything you just articulated is exactly my feelings. You could just take that. It's so well articulated. Just give it to me.
And we're done.
Yeah. When I read the book when I was 11, I just felt like somebody was saying all the things that I was feeling, but was too scared to say out loud, you know? Yeah. And there was something about that just was such a relief, you know? I just felt like, oh, thank God, I'm not alone. And then I felt that way reading so many of her different books. And I also was just always struck by the absolute, sometimes startling honesty that she wrote with. It was like, oh my God, nobody's allowed to say that or describe that. Like, those are things we just keep secret. Like, we all feel and we all experience, but we don't talk about. And having somebody talk about it was just, was a big deal. It felt revolutionary, you know? And it also gave us permission to talk about it. So
I think that's a good word, revolutionary. When I interviewed Abby, she said pretty much the same thing you did, and she was amazed at how much it resonated with her, which says to me that this is an intergenerational phenomenon. It's left a lasting impact on readers for generations. So how did you ensure that your adaptation would honor that source material and kind of resonate with longtime fans and new audiences?
Yes. Yeah. What became sort of my guiding mantra was to really try to deliver the spirit of the book, even when, you know, certain changes were necessitated by the process of adapting it. You know what I mean?
Right.
Sitting down to write it, I was like paralyzed at the beginning because I love her, Judy Blume, so much, and I love the book so much. And it felt like, oh God, every word I changed felt like somehow sacrilegious, you know? So it was a lot of like stops and starts when I first sat down. And then at some point I had to give myself that guiding light, you know, which was just, does it make you feel the way the book made you feel? Like, if it does, then you're on the right path and you're doing right by the book. So that was sort of the license I gave myself. And also the guardrails that I gave myself.
Absolutely. I think that's all you can do when you're adapting something that is so cherished. What was it like having her on set? I know she came to set one day.
Yes. She was there for a few weeks, actually.
Oh, okay.
You know, it was so exciting because it just felt like there's a legend among us. Like, everybody was just like, you know, everybody just brightened, you know, there was just kind of a joy that spread out through the set because she was here, and it felt like a living legend, you know, is among us, which just felt really special.
What do you think were some of the challenges you faced adapting the novel to the screen?
Let's see. Well, one of the things that was top of mind was the fact that there's such a timelessness to the book. When I read it in 1990, I didn't know that it wasn't written in 1990. It felt so contemporary to me.
Yeah.
So one of the challenges was I knew I wanted to set it in 1970 when the book was published, but I wanted to be sure that everybody who came of age in every decade, and also girls coming of age today, could relate to it, and that it wouldn't feel distant and sort of inaccessible, like that is something that happened to somebody else. So I thought a lot about how to create imagery that felt sort of universally nostalgic and reminded everybody every decade of their childhood. So a lot of the 1970s production design is not like you know, that 70s show. It's not, you know, right. Like, it's not like right on the, it's not like, you know, hitting
it's
the
not
nail
like
on
satire,
the head.
Tongue in cheek.
Yeah. Like. It's really more, it has sort of more of a universal nostalgia where it could be 80s or 50s or, you know, it could be yeah. a lot of different things. And I think Margaret's room, for instance, that was important to feel like her room could exist today. Like you could walk into a kid's room today that looks similar. So that was, yeah.
Absolutely. And I loved talking to Abby because she, I think she really nailed it. I mean, absolutely nailed it. And yeah. and the rest of the cast, I mean, you pulled together an amazing team. Like you have, you know, Kathy Bates and Rachel mm-hmm. McAdams and Benny Safdie. Like what was your experience working with that, this kind of powerhouse ensemble?
You know, it's so exciting because every day when you get to set, you're just, you know, it's exciting to see what they're going to bring to the table. That's my favorite thing is the surprises that come out of that collaboration, you know? Yeah. And I also really love to encourage the actors to improvise and riff and play. Because I find that it keeps the whole scene alive. And often things come out of that improvisation that I couldn't have written, you know, just little asides and little things that you can't, that just happen, you know, when you throw everybody together in a room and let them like give them free reign to play in character.
Can you give us like an example or even high level?
I had the four girls together. I very mm-hmm. often like push the kids to improvise a bunch. And for instance, Elle, who plays Nancy, says when she's teaching the girls the I must increase my bust
yes.
move, she said, like, they're like, that really works. And she's like, I'm living proof that was her just improvising, you know?
That's amazing.
And I thought it's so, I think, perfectly improvised in character. And also when they see the anatomy book, that is actually, when they see the picture of the, you know, the scientific drawing of the penis, I really just set up the camera, opened the book and said, just say whatever comes to your mind. It was, you know, like there were scripted lines. Yeah. I was like, forget them all. Just say whatever you think, looking at that picture.
That's amazing. And that, and I think that really speaks to you as a director for creating a safe environment where they could play.
Yes. Right? Yeah. And I want that for myself, you know, as a director. So I always, you know, always try really hard to give that to my collaborators.
For sure. I mean, there's a lot of sensitive and personal topics. It talks about obviously puberty, religion, adolescence. How do you navigate portraying those themes in a way that it resonates, but it's also sensitive?
Each of those things were delicate in their own way. I mean, when it came to the religion and sort of spiritual journey, it was important to me that it was handled in a way that felt respectful and beautiful and honest. So I really went to great lengths to make sure all the details are right in the different places of worship. And that you also understood that it wasn't that she was rejecting, you know, religion or these specific religions as much as it was, she just didn't have the feeling of the divine sitting there in these houses of worship. She felt God alone in her room, you know? And that to me was moving, you know. I loved the way she sort of carves out her own sense of the divine. And the puberty aspect was also delicate because there were just things where like, you know, having her try on a bra in a change room, it was just things where you knew that like exactly where the camera needed to be. And if you went even a centimeter lower, it felt wrong, you know?
Excuse me, we're looking for a bra for my daughter.
Well, we don't have many that small, but come with me, dear, I'll measure you. Arms up, dear. Barely a 28, not even a double A. Your best bet is going to be to go with one of these grow bras here. So one day when you do grow, it'll grow with you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
At the end of the day, what do you want audiences, old and new, young and old, male and female, to come away with after seeing this movie?
You know, I hope that they're moved. You know, I hope that they laugh and cry and relate. You know, I think that's what Judy Blume does so beautifully, is like she writes with such an honesty that it's impossible not to relate. At least that's my experience. And so my hope is that the movie achieves that too. Because that to me feels like the magic of Judy Blume.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more.